of Josh Chastney in the 77, Chad Manning. They'll bring them to green out of 4-6 laps to get it done, and we're underway. Will Carey will jump to the lead as they go into turn number one. Here comes Hot Rod back to the outside, down the back straightaway. Now Wallins, Kentucky, Sean Stevens with a big run out of turn number two. Good to the inside of turn number three. Side by side for the second spot down the front straightaway. Lap one will go to Will Carey. At the line, they'll race back towards turn number one. Now Wallins, Kentucky's John Stevens has made it to the runner-up spot. Hasn't been to 411 in several weeks now. But faster than ever in the seven cars, he's trying to run down the 16 of Will Carey to take over the lead of heat race number one. It'll be four to go. Two in the books, four to go. Third and fourth run the Kecks. Hot Rod Joe Keck running third, and Eli back in fourth. Chastney running fifth in the one car, and then it's Chad Manning. Shotgun in the field, cross flags, we're halfway home. Almost a little bit of contact as he exited turn number two down the back straightaway. Racing for the lead, out of turn number four, to be two to go. Two to go down the front straightaway as Stevens continues to work over Carey just a little bit faster. Then the 16 cars, they go down the back straightaway, but he's got to get it done quick because they'll come out of turn number four. It'll be white flag final time around, and they're going to be side by side for the lead. Here we go. White flag is out, one to go. Stevens to the inside, side by side for the lead down the back straightaway, looking at the last lap pass down the back straightaway as they'll head to turn three. It's about a half car through the center of the corner down the front straightaway. Checkered's going to come out. It's going to be a photo finish at the line. Will Carey gets the win. Good race at the line. Hot Rod will bring it home third. It was a good effort for Wallins, Kentucky's John Stevens, but it'll be the 16 car. Your winner of heat race number one in the pole sitter for tonight's 20 lap feature, it'll be Will Carey. For heat race number two, the winner will start outside pole for the feature as they come to the start line. Good start. We're underway. They fire down the front straightaway. Lee Merritt and Luke Ellis drag race to turn number one. Everybody goes to the bottom. Here comes Chris Worsham in the top. Thought about going three wide. Thought better of it down the back straightaway. Here comes Tom Jewell to the inside. Now Ellis will look back to the outside for the lead. Lap one out of turn number four. It's going to go to Knoxville, Tennessee's Lee Merritt. But Jewell is going to look to the inside. Now the 17's trying to go three wide down the back straightaway. Hang on, Chris Worsham got sideways in two. Tom Jewell to the inside for the lead. Down in turn number three, he'll slide up the hill in turn number four. Hang on, Lee Merritt. And the leader of lap two, your new leader, is Tom Jewell. Lee Merritt will settle into second. Good side-by-side battle for third as Scott Lacey looks to the inside of the 17 of Luke Ellis. Still trying to use the outside part of the racetrack. A lot of momentum built up on the outside part. Hang on. Chris Worsham will go around in turn four. And he'll get it going again. We'll stay green. Down the back straightaway. Tom Jewell pulling away in the 17D. Now Luke Ellis starting to look for the second spot on the 14 of Lee Merritt as they'll come to the line this time. It'll be two to go. Two to go. Back into one, now down the back straightaway. Tom Jewell with about a half a straightaway lead in that white 17 car. First appearance of the year here at 411, as you'll see the white flag final time around for Tom Jewell. Lee Merritt still runs second. Luke Ellis trying to make a move for third, and now Chris Nix thinks about making it three wide for second now on the back straightaway. Luke Ellis gives, Nix will go to third, but out of turn number four to be Rogersville, Tennessee's Tom Jewell, who will win heat race number two. Second at the line, going to be a drag race. Lee Merritt will take it over Chris Nix and Luke Ellis fourth. Chris Nix brings it home third. Second to the 14 of Lee Merritt, your winner. In the 17D, he'll start outside pole for tonight's 20 lap feature. It'll be Tom Jewell. Ready to go, Zach Sass and Jed Emmert bringing them to green out of turn number four. Ready to go here tonight to kick off features for round three of the Schaefer'sville Southern Nationals. Ladies and gentlemen, it is shout time. They're nearly three wide as they get into turn number one. They head down the back straightaway. Walls right way up the racetrack. Turn number one down the back straightaway they go. Zach Seiss will jump to the lead. Jet Emmert looks back to the outside. Siegel back to the bottom. He'll be looking for two in a row. Lap one goes to Zach Seiss. Missed the track record in qualifying by 21 thousandths of a second. The nine car has been hooked up. And here comes the 31 of Brad Siegel. Problems in turn one. Bubba Long goes around in turn number one. And the caution is out. Caution is out. The car went to the jig. They got it repaired, replaced the whole front end. Got a win Saturday night. He's looking for two in a row here tonight. Here we go. They get down into turn number one. Zach Seiss will go to the bottom. Now Emmert with a big run off the top. Down the back straightaway. He'll hold second. Here comes McCaseville, Georgia's Drew Deaver in the 12th car. He'll run fourth. Good side-by-side battle for fifth with Floyd Self. And we got a spinner in turn four. It's Brandon Starnes. And the caution is back out. And the five car of James Cold of Sevierville, Tennessee. Good top five rounds. We come back to green. Big pile up on the start. And Walls Ray is all torn up, the 16 car, with heavy damage. James Cole, just talking about him having a nice top five run. He's got heavy damage on the five car. He's got at least a flat tire. He'll be going to the pit area. Jet Emmert and Brad Siegel with something to say about it as they bring them back to green out of turn number four. We're back underway. They race into turn number one. Down the back straightaway we'll go. And problems again over in turn number one. Yellow is out. Zach Seiss will bring them back to green. Out of turn number four. We're back underway. Everybody goes to the bottom. Siegel will look to the bottom for a second. Down the back straightaway. Here comes Drew Deaver around the top. Deaver down the back straightaway. Side by side for third. And he may not be down on the top shelf yet. Drew Deaver around the top. He'll take third from Siegel. Now Jet Emmert looks to the bottom for the lead down the back straightaway. Couldn't get the run. It is still Zach Seiss out front leading in the nine car. Second is Jet Emmert. Third is a toss-up right now between the 31 of Siegel and Deaver in the 12 as they head down the back straightaway. Good race for third. Side by side now. They're going side by side for fifth is Adam Mitchell looking to the bottom of the 22 of Zach Shannon. Down the back straightaway they go. Maybe the bottom starting to come to life a little bit as Siegel will take over the third spot now. Deaver back to the outside. As we complete six laps in the books, 14 to go. Could be in good shape here. Looks like they've blown the middle of the racetrack off. And the top and the bottom, two distinct good grooves here tonight as Deaver scrapes the wall out of turn number four. And that may cost him the third spot. It will. Siegel will pull ahead down the back straightaway. Jet Emmert rides in the second spot, trying to run down Zach Seiss as they head down the front straightaway. Back into one they go. Jet Emmert pushes way up the hill. It's going to cost him. Here comes Siegel down the back straightaway. Jet Emmert pushing way up the hill. Now Siegel will go to the inside in turn number three. He'll look for second down the front. About a half a straightaway lead for Zach Seiss as they get back into turn number one. Jet Emmert pushes up through the center of the corner again. Holds the spot down the back straightaway. Deaver is settled into fourth, and Zach Shannon will take over the fifth spot from Adam Mitchell. But they'll continue to battle for that spot out of turn number four as we are halfway. 10 in the books, 10 to go. Final time. As Grant Corum has got problems in the 49 car, he pulls up lane down the front straightaway, goes to the infield, and will stay green. And it's only going to be a couple of laps here. The leaders are going to be in lap traffic. As Zach Seiss is starting to catch the tail of the field, and it's four cars right on top of each other. That could be big trouble for the leader as Jet Emmert is starting to run him down. Jason Sizemore off the pace, so is Bubba Long as they run through three and four. Zach Seiss down the front straight. Leader, good battle for second. Here comes Brad Siegel around the 98. You got a new second place car. It's Brad Siegel out of turn number two. Brad Siegel has found the top side of the racetrack. And he is starting to charge towards Zach Seiss as Shane Taylor will try to get out of the way of the leaders. Now Jed Emmert starting to slip back a little bit as Drew Deaver's running him down the back straightaway. Zach Seiss has now caught the tail end of Floyd Self and Brandon Starnes, who has slowed down the front straightaway. It's going to cost Zach Seiss some time. Here comes Siegel for the lead. He'll head into turn number one, trying to get around the lap car. Seiss going to split him down the back straightaway. He'll get around Starnes, so with a 31 of Siegel. One lap car left to negotiate. It'll be Floyd Self down the front straightaway. Self still holding his own on the top shelf. Now Siegel looks to the middle. Down the back straightaway, problems in turn one. It is Brandon Starnes hard into the wall. Brandon Starnes hard into the wall in turn number one and two, and the caution is out. Jed Emmert running a close third. Can anyone do anything with Zach Seiss in the closing four laps? We're going to find out. We're back underway. Seiss will go to the bottom. Here comes Siegel to the top, looking for a run down the back straightaway. He's got a big run as they get into turn number three. He'll go to the bottom. Looks for the lead down in turn number three. They're three wide for third down the front straightaway. Here comes Siegel for the lead. Contact racing for the lead, and Brad Siegel, your new leader. Brad Siegel has taken the lead down the front straightaway with three laps to go. Zach Seiss running second now. Jed Emmert third. Here comes Deaver trying to rally as Brad Siegel has two laps to go. Two laps to go with a 31. Now Seiss will look back to the bottom. Good battle for third. Here comes Deaver inside the 98 of Emmert. Adam Mitchell has problems down the back straightaway. The 50 car is off the pace as the white flag comes out. Final time around. White flag is out. Final time around. Down the back straightaway. It'll be two in a row. Gets it done with three laps to go. It'll be Seymour, Tennessee's Brad Siegel will win the Sportsman feature. Second will go to Zach Seiss. Third to Jed Emmert. Fourth will go to Drew Deaver. And fifth will go to the D22 of Zach Shannon. So it'll be Emmert third. Zach Seiss comes home second. It'll be Seymour, Tennessee's Brad Siegel. And Seiss may not be very happy with him. They're going to stop and talk about it up in turn number one. But making it two in a row, it is Seymour, Tennessee's Brad Siegel. Getting it done again here tonight, two in a row. Ruben Mayfield in 00 and the G2 of Jerry Green. Coming to green this time out of turn number four to go 30 laps. For the crates, it's Ross White, Corey Hitchcock. We are underway. Ross White did not get a good start. Corey Hitchcock jumps to the lead. Now they go battling down the back straightaway for the lead. Jason Wilson sitting in third. Here comes Jesse Lowe to the outside and shorty Greg Martin sliding around the outside part of the racetrack into the fifth spot. Lap one goes to Corey. Down the back straightaway they go. Wilson battling for second with Ross White. Here comes Jesse Lowe to the outside. He'll look for third side by side with Jason Wilson. Wilson will hold on to third. Now Greg Martin will go to the bottom in turn number one to battle with Jesse Lowe for fourth. Down the back straightaway, it's a gaggle of cars right behind them. And problems, it's Jason Manley over in turn number one and two. The caution is out. It is Jason Manley, the Loudoun, Tennessee driver. Corey Hitchcock will bring him out of turn number four. Back to the green flag. We're back underway. Ross White and Jason Wilson will battle for second. Here comes Ross White for the lead down in turn number one. It can't make it stick. Three wide for third down the back straightaway as Wilson will hold on. Greg Martin getting racy around the outside part of the racetrack. Here comes Wilson for second down the front straightaway. They race back into turn number one. Wilson look to the bottom. Down the back straightaway, Ross White will hold with momentum off the top. Fourth is Martin around. Jesse Lowe will sit fifth as they race down the front straightaway. It is still Corey Hitchcock out front in 23 leading. Jason Wilson continues to work the bottom in the two cars. They go down the back straightaway. As Cameron Skinner gets sideways down the back straightaway, will stay green. completing five laps now, 25 to go. And hard into the wall and upside down, Cherry Green rides the fence. Bad crash down the front straightaway as Cherry Green went up into the catch fence in the G2 car. It tears the catch fence up down in turn number four. The caution is out. Cherry Green tagged the turn four wall. He got up into the catch fence. Who will look to pounce for the lead? We're back underway. 15 laps to go over the crates. Back into turn number one they go. Jason Wilson may have a good fight for second down the back straightaway. Slides up in turn number two. Now here comes Ross White back to the outside as they get into turn number three. Side by side for second. They're going to get together and Ross White has to give way. Jason Wilson will take over second. Keep your eyes on the tank. Shane Tankersley making his way towards the top five down the back straightaway. So is Pierce McCarter. Sixth and seventh respectively all over J.C. Lowe as they come out of turn number four down the front straightaway. Ross White has got a gaggle of cars attacking him for the third spot as they go down the back straightaway. Corey Hedgecock out front leading Jason Wilson is second in the Danny Yoder Motorsports number two machine as they get back into turn number one. And Wilson trying to run down the 23 of Corey Hedgecock for the lead. Ross White sits third. Martin is settled into fourth. Jesse Lowe holds down fifth. Good battle for sixth between Shane Tankersley and the 71 of McCarter. They go back to one right around the rim of the racetrack up top. Some cars opting to try the bottom line as they go down the back straightaway, but most of everyone prefers the top side of the speedway. For the meantime, as we are halfway, 10 in the books, 10 laps to go in this feature cut short. After Cherry Green got up into the catch fence, we had a delay for fence repair and an injured fan and cutting the laps to 10 to go now, 9 to go for your leader, Corey Hedgecock, down the back straightaway, who is starting to pull away slowly from the two of Jason Wilson, trying to run him down. But Corey Hedgecock is out front and sailing away in clean air. Best battle on the racetrack appears to be Jesse Lowe trying to go after Greg Martin for the fourth spot as they get into turn number three. McCarter has got sixth away from Tankersley, who is seventh. Kyle Courtney is eighth. Josh Henry is ninth. And Jason Trammell holds the tenth spot. Jesse Lowe continues to battle with Greg Martin as they get into turn number three for fourth. Down the front straightaway now, Wilson looks to maybe be closing just a little bit on Corey Hedgecock. Corey tries the bottom down in turn number one and two, and that's going to allow Wilson to close up. They both go back to the top now in turn number three as they exit four. It'll be five laps to go, five to go for Hedgecock. He goes back to the bottom and one again. We'll see if Wilson gets the good run out of two. Maybe the top start to give up just a little bit as Wilson closes in on your leader. Down the front straightaway into turn number one. Wilson trying to run down your leader, Corey Hedgecock, as they catch lap traffic. It'll be three laps to go this time. Your leaders are in lap traffic. Two to go next time by for Corey Hedgecock. And this feature has went green now to lap traffic. Can Corey Hedgecock clear Crittenden and the 33X of Skinner to catch back and stay ahead of the two of Wilson? Wilson will go to the bottom in turn number one with two laps to go down the back straightaway. It's one lap car that separates them. Corey Hedgecock has cleared both the lap cars, and he will see the white flag out of turn number four. Final time around for Corey Hedgecock. Final time as Jason Wilson dives for it down in turn number one and two, couldn't get there. Has he got one more stab as he gets into three and four? They both go to the bottom. It won't work. It'll be the Loudon Lightning. Corey Hedgecock will pick up the crate feature. Second will get a Wilson. Third at the line, Ross White. Greg Martin goes fourth, and Jesse Lowe rounds out the top five. Came up a little bit short, your winner tonight in the crate feature. It'll be the Loudon Lightning, Corey Hedgecock. Your 20-car feature field, 20-lap feature. 12 cars to get it done. Here we go. As Will Carey and Tom Jewell will bring them to the start line. Out of turn number four, they fire, and we are underway. Racing down into turn number one, it'll be Will Carey. He'll jump to the leader. Comes Jewell to the outside, down the back straightaway. Problems, it's Eli Keck. Eli goes around down in turn number one. The caution is out. Will Carey, Tom Jewell, going to try it again out of turn number four to bring him to green. Good start, we're underway. As they battle down into turn number one, Jewell may have the jump for the lead now as they go down the back straightaway, and Chad Manning will go around in 77. He'll keep it going, will stay green down the back straightaway. Tom Jewell will dive to the inside of turn number three. He'll slide up the hill. Lap one will go to Tom Jewell. John Stevens gives on Will Carey as they came out of turn number four. Hang on, Lee Merritt got sideways in the middle of the corner, but he saves it. They're three wide. Down the back straightaway for third. Here comes Will Carey for the lead. Will Carey back around Tom Jewell. He retakes the lead in 16. John Stevens trying to go for it as well. There'll be a slide job up in turn number one and two as Tom Jewell looked at the inside of Will Carey. Back to turn number three. Now John Stevens wants to join the party for the lead as they three cars. You could throw a blanket over them for the lead as they head down into turn number one. Stevens now will look to the inside of Jewell for second as Chesney is off the pace. We got problems in turn four. The caution is out. It is the three car of Chris Worsham who goes around. We'll see if he can work his way up onto the podium as they come out of four. They fire. We're back underway. Racing into turn number one. Here comes Jewell for the lead. He's going to slide up. Hang on. He gets into Carey. And there goes John Stevens down the back straightaway. Here comes Hot Rod. And it gets interesting for the lead on the restart. Out of turn number four, he goes from third to the lead. Wallace, Kentucky's John Stevens is to the point. New leader in the seven car. Will Carey gets sideways. Here comes Hot Rod down to the inside for second in the back straightaway. Yes, there's contact down the back straightaway with Luke Ellis. Spinner over in turn number one and two, and the caution will have to come out. And now Chad Manning around in turn number three. Caution is out. And Nick still running in the top five as we'll bring him back to green out of four. We're back underway. Hot Rod looking to make a move for second as they get into turn number one. You go to the bottom. Down the back straightaway they go. Nick sits on the bottom as well. Here comes Jewell on the top side. And he's going to look to pull alongside of Hot Rod for the third spot. Will Carey right behind John Stevens as they come out of turn number four. Nearly three wide for the third spot as they got down into turn number one. Hot Rod gets sideways in the middle. They go three wide down the back straightaway. Look at Jewell, fifth to third. The 17 car, Tom Jewell, fifth back to third around the outside part of the racetrack as they head down the front straightaway. Back in the one to go. They'll head down the back straightaway. Will Carey trying to run down your leader. John Stevens in the seven car. As they get into turn number three, they're rim riding around turn number four. Completing six of 20 laps, it'll be 14 to go. As Jewell gets a little bit sideways down in turn number one, they continue down the back straightaway. Hot Rod trying to run him down for third. And now the battle for six is going to heat up with Lee Merritt in the 14 and Scott Lacey. Will Carey seems to be slowly inching his way back towards the back bumper of the seven of Stevens. And he may be running about a half a groove higher in the center of the corners, getting a big run as they head down the front straightaway. Battle for third starting to heat up between Hot Rod and Jewell as they go down the back straightaway out of turn number two. Fifth runs Nix, and then it's a gaggle of cars for sixth, seventh, eighth, and ninth, led by Lee Merritt down the back straightaway. Mid-pack racing, Luke Ellis is going to go to the top side. Everybody has to get on the binders out of turn number four as they slid up the racetrack. And Chesney digging on the bottom of the racetrack. Scott Lacey in the middle as they go down the back straightaway. Now down the front straightaway into turn number one. Will Carey starting to run down John Stevens. He has almost caught the leader as they head down the back straightaway. I don't believe there'll be enough time for the leaders to get to lap traffic, so it shouldn't be an issue as we complete 12 laps. It'll be 8 to go. Hot Rod made a couple of stabs at the 17 of Jewel for the third spot. Couldn't get there. They still run nose to tail through 3 and 4 as John Stevens and Will Carey have pulled away. And now Carey gets sideways in turn number 1, and that's going to cost him a ton of real estate. He loses about 5 car lengths. And down in turn number 3 and 4, the battle still for that 6th and 7th spot raging on. Down the back straightaway with Scott Lacy, Chesney, Luke Ellis, and Chad Manning in the 77. Good racing. It has a little bit of contact between Chesney and Lacy, but they save it. Out of turn number 4, it'll be 5 laps to go at the line for John Stevens. Problems in turn 3 and 4, and it's your 3rd and 4th place cars. Tom Jewell goes around in 17. Bringing them back to green. Out of turn number 4, John Stevens will fire, and we're back underway with a half a dozen circuits left for the Classics here at 411, back into 1. Will Carey going to look to the bottom, just under the 7 car of Stevens. Could not get there as they get to turn number 3. Hot Rod runs 3rd and 78. Chris Nix having a good show in a 9 and 44. He is up to 4th, and Lee Merritt rounds out the top 5 as Tom Jewell starts to work his way from the tail of the field in 17. Down the back straightaway they go. Will Carey trying to get the run on the 7 car of John Stevens down the back straightaway. And now I look back to the inside of the 7, out of turn number 4 with 4 laps to go. Will Carey may have a good run on Stevens as they get out of turn number 2. Couldn't quite make it stick through the center of the corner. Pulling away from Hot Rod, who runs in 3rd. 4th is Nix in the 44. And Lee Merritt runs 5th in the 14. Back down the back straightaway. As they'll come out of turn number 4 this time, it'll be 2 laps to go. 2 to go for John Stevens in 7. As they got a good battle now for 5th as Chad Manning looks under Lee Merritt. But it's Will Carey putting heavy pressure on John Stevens for the lead in the final couple of circuits. It'll be the white flag. Final time around, it'll be 1 to go. 1 to go for John Stevens. Can he hold off Will Carey in the final circuit? Back into 1. They'll head down the back straightaway. Will Carey tries to get a run out of turn number 2. John Stevens holds his own down the back straightaway into turn 3. And they'll exit corner number 4 to be Wallins, Kentucky's John Stevens, who will get the win in 7. Second will go to Will Carey. 3rd to Hot Rod. 4th will go to Chris Nix. And 5th at the line, it'll be Lee Merritt. Good race. Hot Rod brings it home 3rd. Will Carey gave it all he had, but it's Wallins, Kentucky's John Stevens, who will come away with the win in the 7.